Pursuit of Vengeance is a Shaw Brothers martial arts film. This one's directed by Chor Yuen, who I notice he likes to imbue a lot of mystery in his films. This one is about six martial arts figures who are invited to the Wan Ma school. And among them, Ti Lung plays a gruff hero. There's also a jokey guy and another guy who's sent after them. And this movie's full of ambushes. That's kind of like the meat of the story. You know, it's the equivalent of you go into a restaurant and everyone, you know, you order some wine and some meat, and all of a sudden five guys with swords come out of the kitchen. You know, that's kind of like the bulk of the story. But basically, the six people are invited to the Wan Ma school because there has been a sort of blood feud. The Wan Ma school, they killed the leader of another school, and his son is surviving and might be one of the six. So that person, you know, hidden among them is trying to pursue vengeance. And the fight choreography of this movie isn't that great, to be honest. There's a lot of ambushes, and the ambushes are usually people that, you know, get killed immediately. So it's there's not much in terms of choreography wise, but it's really cool to see, you know, all your favorite martial artists duke it out once in a while and leave a trail of bodies. Ti Lung has the same weapon as from The Magic Blade, which is probably, The Magic Blade's one of my favorite Shaw Brothers films, probably easily top three or five. And that weapon's cool. And then his jokey friend basically doesn't have a weapon. He's a grappler of sorts. So he's just so good at martial arts that he blocks swords. Not like the iron skin thing, but like just literally like he's just really fast and strong. And they get pursued by this eccentric assassin with a pole. So there's a lot of twists and turns in this movie. It keeps you on your toes. The real star is definitely the mystery and the twists. You never know what's going on, to be honest. Like, you know, one moment everyone's eating dinner and all of a sudden five guys come out of the kitchen. That's just an example. That's not something that happens in the movie. But that's basically like the sort of, you know, the tone of the film is that it's unpredictable. Action could happen at any moment. And it's a pretty enjoyable in that terms, but a very thin story. And the movie does have a lot of good laughs too. There's some great funny moments, some great character moments. The movie does have like this sort of tone similar to Last Hurrah for Chivalry. So I think that movie came out after. Yeah, so this movie inspired Last Hurrah for Chivalry, I guess, because this one came out in 1972, and I think Last Hurrah is 1979. Yeah, so this movie inspired Last Hurrah for Chivalry, so that's one of my favorite films, and this film definitely is influential in that way, even though it doesn't have much in terms of fighting. It's still a fun romp. So I give Pursuit of Vengeance a 6 out of 10.